This is why it is a must upon us, and this is an individual obligation upon each and every one of us. It is a must upon every one of us, my beloved brothers, to adorn oneself with patience. And pay attention to this expression, to adorn yourself with. The closest the servant would be to his Lord is when he is prostrating in sujood. And sujood, prostration, is one foundational pillar of the pillars of salah.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد الصادق الوعد الأمين وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى صحابته الغر الميامين وعلى من دعا بدعوته وسار على نهجه إلى يوم الدين وبعد فمرحبا بكم أيها الإخوة الأحبة.
I welcome you, my beloved brothers and my noble sisters, in this meeting that gathers me with you, studying the book of Allah Ta'ala from the Masjid Dar al-Ulum in Toronto, Canada.
في هذه الليلة المباركة إن شاء الله.
In this blessed night, with the will of Allah.
التي نسأل الله تبارك وتعالى لنا ولكم ولسائر المسلمين خيرها.
Which we ask for ourselves, yourselves, and the rest of the Muslims, the goodness of this night.
ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى ونعيذكم ونعيذ سائر المسلمين من شرها.
And we seek refuge with Allah for ourselves, yourselves, and the rest of the Muslims from its evil.
ومن الشر التي قبلها ومن الشر التي بعدها.
And from the evil of the night before it and the night after it.
ليلة الجمعة المباركة.
The night of the blessed Friday.
الموافقة للثالث من شهر جمادى الآخرة.
Matching the third of جمادى الآخرة.
لسنة 39 و400 وألف من الهجرة.
1439 هجرة.
الموافق لليلة التاسعة عشرة من ليالي شهر كانون الثاني يناير.
Which matches with the night preceding the 19th of January.
لسنة 18 و2000 من تاريخ الفرنجة.
The year 2018, the Gregorian calendar.
وفي هذا المجلس أيها الإخوة الأحبة.
And in this session, my beloved brothers.
والأخوات الفاضلات.
And my noble sisters.
سنحاول إن شاء الله تبارك وتعالى.
We will try with the will of Allah تبارك وتعالى.
أن نعيش مع قول الله تبارك وتعالى.
To live with the statement of Allah تعالى.
في آية من آيات سورة البقرة.
In one verse from the verses of Surah Al-Baqarة.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة.
O you who believe, seek help through patience and prayer.
إن الله مع الصابرين.
Surely Allah is with those who are patient.
وهذه الآية أيها الإخوة الأحبة.
This verse, oh my beloved brothers.
من الآيات العظيمة.
They are from the great verses of the Quran.
التي أنعم الله سبحانه وتعالى بها على عباده وأحبته.
Which Allah عز وجل bestowed as a favor on His servants.
فإذا ما فهموها فهما صحيحا.
If they understand it, the correct understanding.
وانطلقوا للعمل بها عملا مخلصا.
And they go on and embark upon acting upon it with sincerity.
فإن فيها خيرا عظيما.
Then there is a great goodness in it.
لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى.
That is because Allah تبارك وتعالى.
خلق هذا الإنسان في هذه الحياة الدنيا.
He سبحانه وتعالى created the human in this worldly life.
ليبتليه.
So that he will test and examine him.
كما قال سبحانه وتعالى.
As Allah تعالى said.
والذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا.
He is the one who created death and life to test you, in order to test you. Who amongst you is best in doing good deeds?
فَنَحْنُ مَخْلُوقُونَ لِلِابْتِلَاءِ.
So we are created in order to be tested and examined.
وقال أهل العلم
The people of knowledge said
أن الابتلاء
that trials or being tested
المقصود في هذه الآية ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا
What is meant in this ayah in which Allah says to test you who amongst you is best in doing good deeds
العمل الخالص لله تبارك وتعالى
They said that it is the action that is sincerely done for the sake of Allah تعالى
والموافق لسنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم
The action that also agrees with along with sincerity it agrees and matches with the sunnah of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم
وقد عبروا عنه باختصار في كلمتين
And the scholars have expressed this briefly in a nutshell in two words
ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا
to test you who amongst you is best in deeds
أي أخلصه وأصوبه
most sincere and most correct of the deeds that is
فهذا مختصر المراد
so this is the summary of what is intended
من الابتلاء
from being tested
ولذلك قبل أن يبتلينا الله تبارك وتعالى
This is why before Allah tested us
نبهنا إلى حل جذري
Allah brought our attention to a solution that is a wholesome collective solution
يعيننا فيه سبحانه وتعالى
in which Allah سبحانه وتعالى is assisting us
على تجاوز هذا الابتلاء وهذا الامتحان
to pass this trial or to pass this test
فبين لنا هذه المعونة
so Allah clarified to us this help and assistance
وأمرنا أن نستعين بها
and He commanded us to seek help through that
ألا وهي الصبر والصلاة
and that is patience and prayer
والصبر أيها الإخوة الأحبة خلق عظيم.
Patience, my beloved brothers, is a great character.
وهو من الأعمال القلبية.
It is a great quality. It is from the actions of the heart.
والأخلاق الباطنية الحميدة.
And it is from the inner morals that are praiseworthy.
ولا يتمتع به إلا أحباب الله.
No one enjoys this kind of quality except the beloved ones to Allah.
لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى يحب الصابرين.
Because Allah عز وجل loves those who are patient.
ومعيته مع الصابرين.
And He is with and He accompanies those who are patient.
ولذلك جعل أعظم خلقه صبرا الأنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
This is why he سبحانه وتعالى made the greatest of the creations to have patience the prophets.
واصطفى من هؤلاء الأنبياء أولي العزم من الرسل.
And he chose and selected from those many prophets the prophets who are called the mighty prophets or the ones who have strong will amongst the prophets. أولي العزم.
وأمر نبيه وحبيبه محمدا صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم
and he commanded his prophet and beloved one محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم
أن يكون صبره كصبر أولئك الذين أوتوا العزم من الرسل
that he should be patient the patience of those as the patience of those who have been given strong will amongst the prophets
فقال له فاصبر كما صبر أولو العزم من الرسل
So Allah عز وجل said to him عليه الصلاة والسلام be patient like the those prophets who have strong will have been patient
وقد ابتلى الله تبارك وتعالى بعض أنبيائه
and Allah سبحانه وتعالى tested some of his prophets
أكثر من بعض
more than the other prophets
فمن صبر في الابتلاء
So the one who is patient in those trials and tests
لازلنا نتلو في كتاب الله تبارك وتعالى
We still continue to recite within the book of Allah تعالى
ثناء الله عليه بصبره
How much he praised those prophets by them being patient
مثل أيوب عليه السلام
Like أيوب عليه الصلاة والسلام Job
الذي يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى فيه
Whom Allah says regarding him
إنا وجدناه صابرا.
Surely we found him to be a patient person.
نعم العبد.
what a great servant of Allah he is.
إِنَّهُ أَوَّابٌ.
He is truly someone who always returns in awe to Allah.
وَكُلُّ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ عَلَيْهِمُ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ صَبَرُوا.
And all of the prophets, peace be upon them, all of them were patient.
سواء على الضراء أو على السراء.
Whether in good times or in bad times.
ولذلك جعل الله سبحانه وتعالى الصبر على الضراء والسراء.
This is why Allah عز وجل made patience in times of ease and patience in times of hardship.
من صفات الأبرار.
This is from the qualities of the righteous and pious ones.
فقال سبحانه وتعالى في صفات الأبرار.
So he said سبحانه وتعالى regarding the description of the righteous.
والصابرين في البأساء والضراء.
Those who are patient in times of hardship and in times of harm.
وحين البأس.
And at the time of severe calamities or fighting.
ولذلك نجد في هذه الآية التي تلوناها ابتداء.
This is why we find in this verse that we recited in the very beginning.
والتي جعلناها عنوانا لمجلسنا المبارك معكم أيها الإخوة الأحبة.
Which we made it as a title for our session with you, my brothers, beloved brothers.
والأخوات الفاضلات.
And my noble sisters.
نجد فيها يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر.
O you who believe, we find in this verse, O you who believe, seek help through patience and prayer.
لأن الإنسان كما أخبر بذلك النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Because the human, as the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم informed,
ما أعطي عطاء خيرا من الصبر.
He is not given a gift. He is not given a giving better than patience.
لأن الصبر مفتاح لكل فرج.
That is because patience is a key to every type of relief. And from the parables or the examples that we memorized when we were young, and we comprehended and understood when we are older, that patience is the key to relief. This is why it is a must upon us, and this is an individual obligation upon each and every one of us. It is a must upon every one of us, my beloved brothers, to adorn oneself with patience. And pay attention to this expression, to adorn yourself with patience. To beautify yourself with patience.
الإنسان إذا أكل شيئا مرا.
The human, if he would eat something that is bitter.
في العادة يتحلى بشيء حلو بعده.
After that, he would eat something that is sweet.
فالصبر أيها الإخوة الأحبة هو الذي يجلب الحلى لهذا الإنسان.
So patience, my brothers, is what actually brings sweetness. To the human.
فينبغي على كل واحد منا أن يتحلى بالصبر مع أن الصبر مر.
Each one of us should adorn himself and sweeten himself with patience, although patience is bitter.
ولكن حين تلتزم به استجابة لأمر الله.
But when you stick to patience out of you, abiding by the command of Allah.
يصبح حلية لك.
Then it will turn into something that is actually sweet for you.
وتجد له حلاوة.
And you find the sweetness of it.
ولذلك ينبغي علينا أن نعي هذا الأمر الرباني.
This is why we must comprehend this lordly command.
وأن نتحلى بالصبر.
And that we should adorn and sweeten ourselves with patience.
ولا يمكن للإنسان أن يحصل أي شيء مما يريد.
And the human can never attain anything of his goals
إلا بالصبر.
Except through patience.
ولذلك أمرنا الله عز وجل في هذه الآية أول ما أمرنا.
This is why Allah commanded us in this verse first when He commanded us
بالاستعانة به.
To seek help through Him.
ولماذا قدمه على الصلاة؟
To seek help through patience, that is. Why is it that Allah mentioned seeking help through patience first, then salah?
فقال يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة.
So he said, سبحانه وتعالى, seek help through patience and prayer.
لأن الصبر نابع من الداخل من القلب.
That is because patience stems from and springs from the inside, from the heart.
والصلاة بحد ذاتها تحتاج إلى صبر.
And salah in itself, it requires patience.
ولذلك قدمه ليكون توطئة للصلاة.
This is why Allah mentioned patience in order to be like a forward, an introduction to prayer.
التي هي معراج لهذا العبد إلى الله تبارك وتعالى.
Prayer, which is a means for the servant to ascend up unto Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
فالإنسان بالصلاة يصبح قريبا من الله.
Because the human, by praying, he would be close, he would become close to Allah.
أقرب ما يكون العبد من ربه وهو ساجد.
The closest the servant would be to his Lord is when he is prostrating in sujood.
والسجود ركن أساسي من أركان الصلاة.
And sujood, prostration, is one foundational pillar of the pillars of salah.
فمن أراد أن يكون قريبا من الله.
So the one who wants to be close to Allah.
فليسجد لله.
Let him prostrate in sujood for Allah.
ولينادي الله سبحانه وتعالى بكل ما يريد.
And let him speak privately to Allah with whatever he wishes.
يدعوه بما يحب.
Calling upon him with whatever he loves.
كما أمر بذلك المصطفى عليه الصلاة والسلام.
As the Mustafa صلى الله عليه وسلم commanded us to do so.
فقال أقرب ما يكون العبد من ربه وهو ساجد.
He said عليه الصلاة والسلام, the closest the servant would be to his Lord while he is prostrating in sujood.
فأكثر الصلاة.
So
فأكثر الدعاء.
So make a lot of دعاء then.
والدعاء هو صلاة أصلا.
And دعاء itself is actually صلاة, is a prayer. Supplication is prayer.
ولذلك على المسلم حين يبتلى بشيء.
This is why it is upon the Muslim when he is tested and tried with something.
أن يفزع إلى الصلاة.
He should rush to prayer, صلاة.
كما كان يفعل المصطفى عليه الصلاة والسلام.
As the Mustafa صلى الله عليه وسلم used to do.
كان إذا حزبه أمر فزع إلى الصلاة.
He used to, عليه الصلاة والسلام, if something difficult comes, then he would rush to prayer.
وكان لا يجد راحته إلا فيها.
And he used to, عليه الصلاة والسلام, he doesn't find peace and tranquility except in salah.
وحين يريد أن يأمر بلالا ليقيم الصلاة.
And when he wants to command Bilal to call the إقامة for prayer.
لم يكن يقول له يا بلال أقم الصلاة.
He wasn't saying to Bilal أقم الصلاة.
يقول لبلال أرحنا بها يا بلال.
He says bring comfort to us with it, O Bilal.
لأنه يجد راحته فيها.
Because he finds peace and comfort in salah.
بل كان يقول وجعلت قرة عيني في الصلاة.
Rather, he used to say, عليه الصلاة والسلام, the coolness of the eye, that is complete and perfect satisfaction, for me is made in salah. That's what he used to say, عليه الصلاة والسلام, about himself.
وكذلك أصحابه الكرام رضي الله تعالى عنهم.
Likewise, his noble companions, may Allah be pleased with them.
بعض الصحابة مثل عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه.
Some of the companions like Abdullah bin Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him.
كانت قرة عينه في الصلاة أيضا.
His satisfaction, his complete peace and tranquility, he finds it in salah.
فكان لا يكثر من صيام النوافل.
So he used not to fast a lot voluntarily.
لأنها تضعفه عن الصلاة.
Because it makes him weak to pray.
والصلاة أحب إليه من صيام النوافل.
And salah is more beloved to him than fasting, voluntary fast.
فالصلاة أيها الإخوة الأحبة.
So prayer, O my beloved brothers.
من عظيم شأنها عند الله عز وجل.
From the great status and value it has with Allah.
أنه فرضها فوق سبع سماوات.
That Allah made it obligatory from above seven heavens.
استدعى نبيه صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم من المسجد الحرام في مكة.
He called upon his messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to come from al-Masjid al-Haram in Mecca.
إلى المسجد الأقصى في بيت المقدس
to up to going to المسجد الأقصى in Jerusalem
ثم عرج به إلى السماوات السبع
then he brought him up and made him ascend above the seven heavens
وإلى سدرة المنتهى
and up until the Lot tree
وفرض عليه هذه الصلوات الخمس في اليوم والليلة
and he made obligatory upon him these five daily prayers in one night and one day
لعظيم شأن هذه الصلاة
that is because of the great status prayer has
وكان في مقدوره سبحانه وتعالى
he is all able سبحانه وتعالى
أن يفرض الصلاة عليه وهو في مكة كما سائر الشرائع التي فرضها عليه
he was all able to make the salah an obligation like the rest of the obligations he could have commanded him to do so in Mecca while he's still in Mecca
ولذلك الله سبحانه وتعالى لعظيم شأن هذه الصلاة
this is why Allah عز وجل because of the great status that salah has
قبل من نبيه عليه الصلاة والسلام مراجعته فيها
he accepted from his prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to go back and refer back to him regarding it
مع أن قوله سبحانه وتعالى فصل وليس بالهزل
although his statement سبحانه وتعالى is so decisive there is no jokes in it
ولا يخير عباده أن يفعل أو لا يفعل
and he does not give the choice to his servants to do or not to do
أما في الصلاة مع عظيم شأنها
as for salah يعني along with its great status and value
فإن الله سبحانه وتعالى قبل من نبيه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم
الله عز وجل accepted from his prophet محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم
أن يراجعه مرة ومرتين وثلاثة وأربعة وخمسة
to refer back to him and consult with him again one, two, three, four, five times
حتى أنزل هذه الصلوات من خمسين إلى خمس
up until Allah عز وجل reduced the obligation from 50 prayers up until just 5 prayers in one day and one night
وجعل تعدادها خمسا في الفعل
and Allah made the numbering to be 5 daily prayers in terms of actions and doing
وخمسين في الأجر والثواب
yet they have 50 in terms of reward
فأرأيتم هذه الصلاة التي صليناها الآن في هذه الليلة؟
So have you seen and you could tell me about this salah that we prayed now in this night?
إذا كانت عندنا النية الجازمة الصارمة
If we had the strong and sharp will
أن نصلي الفجر أيضا في الجماعة كما صلينا العشاء في الجماعة
To pray Fajr prayer in congregation like we prayed Isha prayer in congregation
نكون في حال النوم
then we will be while we are sleeping
ويكتب لنا أجر الصلاة
then the salah the reward of salah will be still written for us
يقول عليه الصلاة والسلام
he says عليه الصلاة والسلام
من صلى العشاء في جماعة فكأنما قام نصف الليل
the one who prays عشاء in congregation as it is as if he prayed قيام الليل night prayer for half of the night
ومن صلى الفجر في جماعة فكأنما قام الليل كله.
And the one who prays Fajr in congregation, it's as if he prayed night prayer all night long.
ولذلك لو أن أحدا منا وهذا ممكن.
This is why if one of us, and this is something that is possible.
مات هذه الليلة.
He would die this night.
يموت على عمل صالح.
He will die upon a good deed.
وقد أدى هذه الفريضة العظيمة
when he has performed this great obligation
وختم الله بصالح عمله
and Allah عز وجل sealed his actions with a good deed
وهذا يدفعنا أيها الإخوة الأحبة
and this leads us my beloved brothers
أن نحافظ على هذه الطاعة التي أديناها
that we should guard and preserve this obedience that we have performed and that we should not corrupt it with a disobedience from the disobedience so that our end if our end comes
نكون قد ختمنا حياتنا بعمل صالح.
Then we would have ended our lives with a good deed.
بل بأصلح عمل يمكن أن يلقى الإنسان به ربه عز وجل.
Rather, we would have ended our lives with the most rectified, most reformed, or the best good deed that we can finish our lives with.
فنكون قد طبقنا أمر الله سبحانه وتعالى.
So then we would have applied Allah's command.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة.
O you who believe, seek help through patience and prayer.
ولا ننسى خاتمة الآية.
We should not forget the end of this verse.
إن الله مع الصابرين.
Surely Allah is with the patient ones.
فإذا ما صبرنا على هذه الطاعة التي أديناها.
So if we are patient to do this obedience that we performed.
ولم نعصي الله عز وجل بعدها.
And we were patient not to disobey Allah عز وجل after doing it.
واستشعرنا معية الله سبحانه وتعالى معنا.
And if we call to mind and sense and feel the accompaniment of Allah with to us, meaning that feeling that Allah is with us.
معية العلم يعلم بحالنا.
The accompaniment of knowledge that He knows our condition.
معية الإحاطة أنه محيط بنا قادر علينا.
The accompaniment of him encompassing us, he has full knowledge and encompassing us.
معية الحفظ أنه يحفظنا سبحانه وتعالى.
The accompaniment of preserving and guarding, that he will guard us سبحانه وتعالى and keep and protect us.
معية التأييد والنصر والتمكين أنه سبحانه وتعالى يؤيدنا وينصرنا ويمكن لنا.
The accompaniment of support, the accompaniment of help and assistance that he will render to us, he will support us and help us.
فنكون قد حققنا هذه الآية بحذافيرها.
So then we would have applied and practiced this ayah to the letter.
ثم هذه الآية جاء التمهيد.
So then this ayah, this verse has come as an introduction, as a foreword
لما بعدها من الآيات
to what comes after it of the verses
التي فيها ابتلاءات
which has within them trials and tests.
ولا تقولوا لمن يقتل في سبيل الله أموات.
Do not say to those who are killed in the way of Allah that they are dead.
فسبيل الله عظيم.
The way of Allah is great.
ويحتاج إلى جهد وجهاد.
It has to have efforts and it has to have efforts that are spent, struggle and striving.
شرعه الله تبارك وتعالى.
Allah عز وجل legislated this.
وجعل له أحكاما.
Allah عز وجل legislated it and had rulings for it.
فيها سعادة الأمة في دنياها وفي أخراها.
Rulings that will lead to the happiness of this ummah, this nation, in this worldly life and in the next life.
ولا يعني الجهاد هذا الذي يفعله الآن السفهاء.
And this does not mean the jihad or the striving that those foolish people are doing, claiming it to be jihad.
ممن ظنوا أن الجهاد فقط هو قتل وقتال.
Those who think that jihad is only restricted to killing and fighting.
وسفك للدماء.
And blood shedding.
وقتل للأبرياء.
And killing those who are innocent.
وتفجير المباني والسيارات والعمارات
bombing and exploding buildings and streets and cars and so on and so forth.
فالجهاد في سبيل الله جاهد النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
So jihad in the way of Allah, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did perform jihad في سبيل الله.
بنفسه الشريفة.
His own self, his blessed self عليه الصلاة والسلام.
طيلة فترة حياته.
He participated in jihad all of his life.
الدعوية.
All of his life in which he spent calling to Allah.
23 سنة وهو يجاهد.
23 years while striving and spending effort in the way of Allah. ابتداء من قول الله عز وجل له. Starting from the statement of Allah to him.
وجاهدهم به جهادا كبيرا.
And strive against them, perform jihad against them with it, that is with the Quran, a great type of jihad or striving.
أي جاهدهم بهذا القرآن جهادا كبيرا.
Meaning strive against them with this Quran, a great striving.
وتدرج معه سبحانه وتعالى.
Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gradually commanded the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
في الجهاد حتى أدخل البشرية في دينه العظيم.
Gradually commanded him to perform more and more jihad up until he entered the humanity in this great religion.
لتسعد هذه البشرية كل البشرية.
So that this humanity, all humanity, will become happy.
بهذا الدين العظيم.
To become happy with this great religion.
فلولا الجهاد في سبيل الله الحق.
Were it not for the true jihad and striving in the way of Allah.
لما رأينا هذه الوجوه الطيبة في هذه البلاد الطيبة أهلها إن شاء الله.
Then we wouldn't have seen these good pure faces in this country that its people are good and pure إن شاء الله.
ومثل هذا البيت الآمن من بيوت الله.
And we wouldn't have seen like this safe house of the houses of Allah.
في أرض الله.
In the land of Allah.
التي وعد سبحانه وتعالى أن تكون للمتقين.
Which Allah عز وجل promised that the land will be for the pious one.
كما قال الله عز وجل لموسى عليه السلام.
As Allah عز وجل said to Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام.
أن يقول لقومه.
That he should tell his people.
حين تذمروا من دين الله.
When they got fed up of the religion of Allah.
قال إن الأرض لله يورثها من يشاء من عباده.
He said for him to say to them that surely the land, the earth belongs to Allah. He will make it the inheritance. He will give it to those whomever he wishes from his servants.
والعاقبة للمتقين.
And the good end will be for the pious ones.
وهذا قد يستلزم أحيانا.
And this may necessitate sometimes.
أن يقتل الناس في سبيل الله سبحانه وتعالى.
That people may be killed in the way of Allah Ta'ala.
وهؤلاء أيها الإخوة أحياء عند الله عز وجل.
And those who die in the way of Allah, they are actually alive with Allah عز وجل.
ونهانا الله سبحانه وتعالى أن نسميهم أموات.
And Allah forbade us from calling them dead people.
بل قال لنا بل أحياء ولكن لا تشعرون.
Rather he said to us, rather they are alive but you cannot feel that or you do not feel it.
ثم الآيات بعد ذلك تتحدث عن الابتلاءات.
Then the verses after that speak about trials and tests.
ولا أريد أن أطيل وأدخل فيها.
I do not want to make this session long and get into those verses.
لكن الملخص المفيد كما يقال.
But the beneficial summary, as it is said.
أن الاستعانة على الابتلاءات.
That in order to seek an assistance for trials and tribulations, tests. If those tests were deficiency in terms of wealth, in terms of children.
أو الأموال.
Or wealth.
أو الأنفس.
Or souls.
أو الثمرات.
Or crops.
فالعلاج لذلك كله.
The treatment for all of that, the cure for all of that, is to seek help through all of that by patience and prayer. All praise is due to Allah who gathered us and you over this good and pure prayer.
وأعاننا وإياكم على الصبر على هذه الدقائق التي تحملتوها من أجل سماعي مثل هذا الكلام.
And helped us and you to be patient in order to listen to these words that you've just heard from me.
وسنستمر في هذا الصبر إن شاء الله.
And we will continue through this patience إن شاء الله.
في الدقائق القادمة.
In the next minutes that are coming.
حتى نعمل بهذه الآية.
So that we will practice and apply this verse.
وقد صبرنا أنفسنا على بعضنا البعض.
And we have been patient with each other.
تحقيقا لقول الله.
Actualizing and establishing the statement of Allah.
واصبر نفسك مع الذين يدعون ربهم بالغداة والعشي يريدون وجهه.
Hold yourself and make it patient to be with those who remember Allah during the morning and the evening seeking His face.
وإني لأرجو أن نكون جميعا.
And I hope that all of us will be
ممن يرجون وجه الله تبارك
to be from those who seek the face, the countenance of Allah
تعالى. وأن نكون ممن صبر نفسه على ذلك.
And to be from those who push themselves to be patient to do just that.
فسأكتفي بهذا.
I will suffice myself with what I said.
إن كان ثمة سؤال من هنا أو من هناك.
So if there is some question from here or there.
نجيب عليه بما ييسر الله سبحانه وتعالى.
We'll respond to it with whatever Allah facilitates and makes easy for us.
سائلين الله عز وجل لنا ولكم.
Asking Allah عز وجل for ourselves and yourselves.
الهدى والسداد.
Guidance and correction.
والتوفيق والرشاد.
And facilitation and to be guided.
والحمد لله رب العالمين.
And all praises due to Allah, the Lord of the worlds.